Hi everyone, welcome to Tech News Curator. This is Julian Ho. In mid-November 2023, the tech industry is still buzzing, and this week was a hot week for semiconductor CEOs to visit Taiwan. Intel's CEO, Pat Gelsinger, came to Taiwan again, and this time he first told the media about his three big mistakes and also threw out a big tech trend in Taiwan. What mistakes did Intel make? What trends does he see? After Gelsinger just left, Jen-sen Huang, the most popular a trillion men in the technology industry this year, came to Taiwan again. Who does the old Huang stand for this time? Who is the real godfather of technology? AI is not only about high-performance computing, but also about critical high-bandwidth memory. Micron's CEO, Sanjay Mehrotra, came to Taiwan to officiate the opening ceremony of the new plant in Taichung. What is Micron's strategy? Tech News Curator will point out the key events of the week for you and organize the industry information that you don't want to miss in the technology industry. First, we saw Intel's CEO, Pat Gelsinger, come to Taiwan again. This time, he first told the Indian media that Intel has made three major mistakes in the past. The outside world has interpreted that these three mistakes have led Intel to a lost decade. First of all, we need to know the background of this. In 2009, Gelsinger left Intel and did not return as CEO until 2021. The first big mistake, the failure of the smartphone-related business. In fact, during Gelsinger's absence, Intel had rejected Apple. The company offer is actually the smartphone chip design and manufacturing orders. Intel chose to build its own chips. However, it did not get the market's attention. And ultimately, Intel's smartphone-related business development ended in a mess in 2016. This decision caused Intel to miss out on the golden age of smartphones. The second major mistake was that Intel had an early type AI GPU architecture product, but eventually canceled the launch plan. Gelsinger was outspoken about the fact that when he was gone, Intel canceled GPU program in 2010, included not only consumer products, but also high-performance computing, HPC, products. The entire program was completely cut, and Intel has not been able to launch a general-purpose GPU chip at all. This decision has led to the fact that the discourse power about AI GPUs is now almost entirely in the hands of NVIDIA, under the leadership of Jensen Huang. The third mistake was that Intel focused on building a great foundry business too late. Gelsinger very honestly pointed out that Intel almost did not put the customer as the center, but thought it was the leader of technology. To put it bluntly, the attitude is too arrogant and also very harsh to customers. In contrast, TSMC, the largest foundry in the world, is completely customer-oriented. And TSMC's CEO, C.C. Wei, once said, "The success of our customers is the success of TSMC." Therefore, Gelsinger told the media that the company is striving for on-time delivery and a culture of discipline. However, this is something that has probably been an iron rule for TSMC for many years. Despite this, Taiwan's PC supply chain is still Intel's good partners. Gelsinger stood with the AA brand Acer, Asus together on stage, this time in Taiwan. He talked about the AI PC trend. We see that NVIDIA in the first half of this year threw out the buy more, save more, AI GPU topic, let the global technology industry sensation, but this is in the cloud AI field. Next, AI will gradually spread to all kinds of edge devices, and of course PCs will be one of them. Gelsinger said that the shipment scale of AI PC is expected to reach 100 million units in the next 2 years. He emphasized that Intel's AI PC blueprint and product strength is the strongest. Now is the important moment of AI PC, but also a turning point in the PC industry. He also directly explained that Taiwan's Acer, Asus, are customers. Now entering the AI era, the future AI will be everywhere. Yes, AI 1 trillion man. And NVIDIA CEO Jensen Huang has come to Taiwan again. And this time he made a surprise appearance to pay tribute to the godfather of the technology industry, Morris Chang, the founder of TSMC. Morris Chang was awarded the first KT Lee Award. And at the award ceremony, to the surprise of all guests, Jensen Huang appeared as a mysterious guest to give a speech. And he said, "Without TSMC, there would be no NVIDIA." Huang recalled that when he first met with Chang for the first time, he was very nervous, and he was only in his early 30s at the time. NVIDIA, which was built on TSMC's foundations, has invented GPUs, which are changing the mode of computing paradigm, and the AI revolution is even bigger than PCs, cell phones, and the internet. Then, working with Chang is like a symphony. Without TSMC, the entire world's technology industry would not be possible today, and Chang is the godfather of Taiwan's technology. And who is the pioneer of Chang's tribute? It was Kuo-Ting Lee, KT Lee, a former senior official of the presidential office. Lee served as Minister of Economy, Minister of Finance, Minister Without Portfolio, and the presidential government's Minister of Finance. Lee laid the foundation of Taiwan's technology industry by establishing the Export Processing Zone, amending the Incentive Investment Law, and setting up the Industrial Technology Research Institute, ITRI, Hsinchu Science Park, and the Institute for Information Industry. TSMC's founder Morris Chang even said, "Without KT Lee, there would be no TSMC." Chang came to Taiwan from Texas Instruments to serve as president of the Industrial Technology Research Institute, ITRI, and later founded TSMC with the support of KT Lee. Chang shared a three-act story about his relationship with Lee. He said, The third act, which is the establishment of TSMC, is quite familiar to people, but I'm afraid not many people know about the first and second acts. In the first act, from 1976 to 1980, Chang, who worked at TSMC, was invited to give a speech in Taiwan, and Li, who was a minister without portfolio at that time, was in the audience. After listening to the speech, he immediately came over and shook hands and made a dinner date. Li wanted to get to know the chairman of Texas Instruments and establish a relationship with Texas Instruments, and then later made a number of visits to the company. In the second act, from 1982 to 1985, Li began trying to invite Chang to Taiwan, but in the end he failed. At that time, Executive Yuan Chairman Yun Suan-sun also joined in the effort to invite Chang to Taiwan, but it was unsuccessful at the beginning, mainly because Chang's stocks, which amounted to $2-3 million, had not yet been cashed out, and Texas Instruments did not allow Chang to stay in his job without pay and retained the right to cash out his stocks. At that time, Li was also angry with Chang's refusal to accept the offer. Between 1982 to 1985, there was a break in the relationship between Chang and Li. It wasn't until 1985 that the chairman of Aitri, Xin Xiushu, sent out an olive branch to Chang again. At that time, Chang had already received his shares in Texas Instruments, so he agreed to the invitation. Chang's first position was as president of Aitri, but behind the scenes, 3 weeks after his appointment, KT. Li told Chang to set up a semiconductor company. The third act was the establishment of TSMC. According to Chang, the business model and the establishment of TSMC were mainly his own ideas, but it was Li who pushed and convinced the government to invest 48%. At that time, he already had many political enemies and people who opposed him. But from 1985 to the founding of TSMC, there would have been no TSMC without the promotion of KT Li. "It is with great honor and humility that I accept this first Quoting Li Award," said Chang. If you want to learn more about the development of Taiwan's semiconductor industry, click on the information card in the upper right corner and refer to the Silicon Island Spring and Autumn documentary produced by DIGITIMES, where we invited industry veterans such as Chin Tae-shi, John Xuan, and Stan Shi to explore the reasons for the success of Taiwan's semiconductor industry. The award ceremony was a great gathering of tech industry veterans. Founder of Hong Hai, Terry Kuo, Qantas Barry Lam, and Acer's Stan Shi were all in attendance, as well as TSMC's current chairman, Mark Liu, and CEO, C.C. Wei. Of course, the irresistible charisma of Jensen Huang, once again visited his favorite night market in Taiwan for a great meal and snacks after the ceremony. Looking back at the history and the present, TSMC, the dominant foundry, is already one of the most influential leaders in the logic chip production chain. However, in the era of AI, the heterogeneous integration of high-performance logic chips and high-bandwidth memory is the key. With the wave of AI, high-bandwidth memory, HBM, will play an important role in the AI era. Memory leader Micron announced the official opening of its fourth plant in Taichung, integrating advanced packaging and testing to mass-produce HBM3E to meet the new demand. Micron's CEO, Sanjay Mehrotra, recently traveled to China to meet with the Ministry of Commerce and then came to Taiwan to officiate at the opening ceremony of the new plant. This investment in local operations will create hundreds of new jobs over the next 10 years and create demand for thousands more in the surrounding ecosystems, Mehrotra said. Micron Taiwan Chairman Donghui Lu also emphasized that Micron in Taiwan, the cumulative scale of investment reached $30 billion, becoming one of the largest foreign investors and employers in Taiwan. Although Micron in the HBM is not the fastest pace, but in the future, Micron will combine the United States, India, Japan, Taiwan, and other multinational teams, and the use of four plants in Taichung, the integration of advanced sealing and testing technology, leading to HBM3E mass production. In the long run, Taiwan is expected to be the only production base where HBM can be vertically integrated, and with the AI frenzy, it is expected that the overall HBM market will still be in short supply. Micron recently announced that in China and India, expanding the back-end packaging and testing capacity, Mehrotra also emphasized that the completion of the fourth plants in Taichung will further strengthen the layout of Micron in the global packaging and testing, including Taiwan, China, Singapore, and Malaysia. Although Micron steps into the HBM later than the industry, but HBM3E appeal bandwidth, capacity, and performance, Micron expects mass production in the first quarter of 2024. HBM design and development will run by the U.S. headquarters, with India to support the front end of the research and development by the Hiroshima. Taiwan, as an advanced packaging town, will join the mass production in the future. Thank you for watching this week's Tech News Curator. Tech News Curator will be aired exclusively on the DIGITIMES YouTube channel every Wednesday at 9:00 a.m. EST. So please like, subscribe, and turn on the little bell to be notified of our updates as soon as they happen. See you next week.